In one of the episodes, we looked at how to send the data from Lightning components to Visual Force pages. Let me fire up the developer console. If you look at the Lightning component, we tried embedding the Visual Force page using an iframe tag, and we used something called SRC. And for this attribute called SRC, the value is name of the Visual Force page. I tried creating one attribute with the name base domain. To this attribute called base domain, I tried giving a default value, and this value is kind of hard-coded. When you try to work in a real project, we'll never be hard coding any values. So now we'll look at a way how to make this dynamic rather than hard coding it here and then using it here. As a part of that, I'll make use of init handler so that when the component initializes, we'll make a call to the apex class, and back in the apex method, we'll try to generate the base domain of the respective Visual Force page, get it back, and we'll try to substitute it here. So back in the client side controller, I need to implement do init. This is going to be do init. Let me copy this and paste it here. Now from here, I need to make a call to the apex method. Name of the apex method is going to be get base domain. Now I need to associate this component with apex class. For that, I would need to create an apex class. Let me wire it up to this component by using the attribute controller. So now the apex class is kind of associated with this component, and then we need to create an apex method with this name. Like there's a typo here. Back in the apex class, this is going to be something like this. And now in this apex method, we need to write the business logic to generate the base domain of a Visual Force page. If you look at the base domain of a Visual Force page, it is going to be of the format custom domain, followed by that we'll have two hyphens c dot instance name dot visual dot force dot com. This is the base domain of a Visual Force page. So as a part of that, I'll try to make use of something called URL class, and the way I'm going to use it is system.url. So this URL class has got few helper methods, and these helper methods will be helping us to get access to the base domain. Before we use it, let us jump onto that class and let us see all the helper methods that we have access to. We copy this. These are all the helper methods that we get access to. And in this helper methods, we'll be making use of something called get Salesforce base URL, which is this. And if you look at what it returns the URL of the Salesforce instance. So let me come back to the developer console. And this is going to be .get Salesforce URL. But when I try to return this, and when I say this as string, it is going to throw us an error. That is because it is not trying to return a string. Rather, it is trying to return something which is of the format system.url. So for this to work, I need to have the return type as system.url. When I try to save this, now it gets saved without any error. But then when you try to receive it back in the callback function, which is here, you'll get null. That is because any variable, any class that we try to use within Aura enabled method has to be Aura enabled, and this class is not Aura enabled. As a part of that, when you try to return something which is not Aura enabled, and when you try to receive it back in the callback function, you'll be receiving nothing but null. So this approach is not going to work, and we need to come up with a workaround so that we should be able to send string from here and we can receive it back in the callback function without any problem. As a part of that, I'll try to make use of one more function, and this function is called toExternalForm. If you look at the documentation, this method called toExternalForm, this is going to return as a string representation of the current URL. So let me copy this. Come back here. Dot of this. Now that we are trying to send a string here, we can have this as string. Let me give this a save. And string class is Aura enabled so that we can receive the actual URL back in the callback function without any problem. And before we go ahead, let me open up the execute anonymous window. Let us try to get a hang of what do we get when we run this command. We close this off for a second. Copy this. I'll paste it here. Let us try to get a hang of what this is kind of returning us. Let me also try to debug and see what do we get when we try to execute this statement without two external form. That is something that I would be interested in. When I try to execute this, I'm going to click on this. So get Salesforce based URL is trying to give us something which is of type URL. Whereas when I add dot to external form, this is going to give us something in the form of string. And if you look at this domain, this is not what we use in our Visual Force pages. If you look at the domain of our Visual Force pages or base domain of the Visual Force pages, that is completely different. That is custom domain followed by that we have two hyphens c dot instance name dot visual dot force dot com. So when I try to make use of this URL and when I try to substitute it here and then run it, it is going to throw an exception. That is because the domain of Visual Force page is something different and the domain that we'll be substituting here will be something different. So what I have to do now is, based on the value that I have got here, I need to somehow form the base domain of the Visual Force page, which is this. So as a part of that, I'm going to take this URL, and to this URL, I'm going to remove everything which is before Teja and after ED, and then we'll be left out with this custom domain. To this custom domain, I'm going to add two hyphens C, and after that, I'm going to dynamically get the name of the instance, which is AP4. To that, I'm going to add dot visual dot force dot com. Let us look at how to do it. Let me go back to the developer console. Let me go back to execute anonymous window. And by now we know that this is going to give us the URL. Let me assign this URL to a variable. Say string custom domain is equals to this. This is going to give me the complete domain, out of which I'm going to strip everything that is before Teja and after ED. The way I'm going to do it is, I'll make use of one helper method in string class, which is substring after HTTPS. So I'm going to remove everything which is before Teja, and then I'll make use of one more helper method, which is substring before. I'll try to get rid of everything which is after dot. So this gives me just the custom domain part, which is this. And up to that, I have to add static string, which is two hyphen C. And then I need to add the instance name. And then I need to add dot visual dot force dot com. These are the three things that I need to do now. So let us look at how to get the instance name first. I'll be querying an object here. The object name is going to be organization. So the query is going to be select instance name from organization. Let me assign this to a variable of type organization. Let me debug what do we get back here. This is going to be system.debug of, let me highlight this. I'm going to execute this. Let me click on this checkbox. So the instance name is AP4, but I have this in all caps. I need to get this down to lowercase. Let me open up the execute anonymous window. So here, say string VF base domain is equals to custom domain, which is this, plus I'll try to add two hyphens C dot, and then I'm going to make use of O dot instance name dot to lowercase. This is the method I'll be using to get everything down to lowercase, and then you got to add something which is dot visual.force.com. Let me end it and let me debug it. Let us check what do we get back. Okay, looks like there is a typo. This has to be instance name. I'm going to click on this. There you go. This is the base domain that we have now, which is custom domain followed by that 2-c.ap4.visual.force.com. And this is very much in sync with the base domain of the Visual Force page. So back in the developer console, let me close this and this and this. I'm going to copy this. I'm going to paste everything here. Let me get rid of all these comments. And also this. And finally, I'll try to return this. Let me give this a save. Back in the callback function, this is going to be response.getReturnValue. And I'm trying to assign this to a local variable, which is return value. Now I'll have to assign this back to the attribute, which is base domain. Component.set. V.baseDomain will be assigned with this value. Let me give this a save. And back in the component, let me remove this default value. Let me save this and let me run this. Now everything should work without any glitch. Okay, that is because we are using component here and CMP here. Let me rerun this. You'll notice that the Visual Force page here is kind of broken down. That is because back in the developer console, once this component renders, after that it is going to call the init handler. So when it is trying to render the component, it doesn't have any value for this attribute called base domain, and hence it is kind of broken down. Let me change this from init to render. You can also change this to handle render. Or you can also leave that as do init, but just to follow the proper naming convention, I'm trying to rename it. Let me save all the files. I think it should work fine now. There you go. We have this component and the Visual Force page. Say something like this. And when I try to send it, there you go. The data transfer happens from the Lightning component to Visual Force page, with the Visual Force page base domain being completely dynamic. Nowhere we are trying to hard code it. This is how we can get the base domain of the Visual Force page in our Lightning components. So that's all for this session. I'll call it a day and see you.